Now, the outcome of that procedure is a sequence of eigenvalues and eigenvectors or eigenfunctions with the following property. So we have eigenvalues lambda I with corresponding eigenvectors ui with norm 1, such that ui is an orthonormal system of eigenvectors. So, okay, ui is lambda I times ui. And the sequence of eigenvalues is decreasing. And the set of lambda I is complete in the following sense, that every eigenvalue occurs in the lambda I, and it occurs as often as it's according to its the space of its eigen, according to the dimension of its eigenspace. So if the dimension of the eigenspace is L, then lambda I occurs L times in that sequence. So in that sense, this sequence is complete. Now, let us define H as the set of all U in X, which can be written in the form U is the sum over all K alpha K times UK. And depending on the structure of the operator, that may be a finite or an infinite sum. I don't really care. But of course, only the infinite sum is the interesting case. Now, let V be an element in H perp. Now, that definitely means that the scalar product of V and any UK is zero. Now, if that is the case, then KV, scalar product with UK, is the same as V, scalar product with KUK. I think we had this already. And that's the same as KUK is lambda K times UK. So this is lambda K times V and UK, and since lambda K, and this is zero. So KV is also in H perp. And well, that means that K is an operator that maps H perp to H perp. Now, since K is compact and self-adjoint with respect to the large space, then it's also self-adjoint and compact with respect to the smaller space, to the subspace. And that means that if K is not zero, then it has an eigenvalue norm k plus or minus norm k, so lambda, which is plus or minus norm k, with corresponding eigenvector, and this is not equal to zero with corresponding eigenvector. So we have pair. We have a pair lambda u of eigenvector and eigenvalue, which are not listed, definitely not listed in the sequence. And in fact, we have, since u is in H perp, u cannot be represented as linear combination of the UK. And this is a contradiction to the assumption that the UK are a complete set. Of eigenvectors. So there's only one thing that's left, k from h perp to h perp is the null operator. Well, or equivalently, the kernel of K is hperp. Now, for the second part, I would like to decompose my space X in the following way. X is H. Plus h perp. Well, this is not completely true. In fact, what we've proved is that x is a closure of h plus h perp. So I would like to show that h is closed. And to do that, let me take a Cauchy sequence in H. So let's take Wn. That should be a Cauchy sequence. In H. Which means that, first of all, the Wn are in H, so they are representable as the sum over all k alpha k n times uk. And since they're a Cauchy sequence, their norm is limited. So the norm of W, there is a constant such that the norm of Wn small or equal to C for all n. Okay, so let's look at the, I want to show that the Wn actually converge and that they converge in H, and that would mean that H is closed. Okay, so let's prove that it actually does that. And let's look at Wn minus Wm. Well, since that's a Cauchy sequence, Wn is a Cauchy sequence that goes to zero for n and m to infinity. But in fact, of course, we can insert the representation of Wn and Wm, and so that's nothing but the sum over all k alpha kn minus alpha km squared. And I've made use of the fact that the UK are an orthonormal system. Okay, so this goes to zero. So that means that for fixed K, alpha KN is a Cauchy sequence, or it converges towards some alpha k. Okay, now let's look at the norm of Wn squared. And as I said, that's bounded, but of course I can write it down in the alpha k's. So that's the sum over all k alpha k n squared. And as I noted, that's bounded, so that's smaller or equal to c square in this case. Okay, so the sum of all k alpha kn is independent of n, if that's smaller than c square, since alpha kn is the limit. That means that also the sum over all k alpha n l, excuse me, alpha k n squared must be smaller or equal to c square. So that means that this sequence, this series is bounded from above by something that's less than infinity. So it converges. And keeping in mind what we started with today, we find that the u, which is equal to sum over all k alpha k times uk, is convergent. So and I call the outcome I call u. And since of course we have that wn converges to u because all the coefficients converge, we find that the Wn converges towards some elements, and from the representation of U, we already see that's in H. So taking a Cauchy sequence in H, we find that it is convergent and that the limit is also in H. And that implies that the closure of H is H. So now we can do what I announced. We write the our space, our basic space X as H plus H perp. So for all U, I think I should formulate this. I had to look up the number. So theorem 2.30. Let K, a compact operator from X to X, compact and self-adjoint, and of course X a Hilbert space. Assume that UK is a set of all orthonormal eigenfunctions or eigenvectors are all set for eigenvalues lambda k not equal to zero, and all in the sense that I just mentioned. So that's the outcome of our procedure, and let U be any element in X, then U can be represented as an element H1 plus H2, where H1 is an element of is an element of H, as defined above, and this is an element of H perp. And if it's H perp, then we already know that H perp is the kernel of K. So that means that k at page two, is 0. And now h1 is in h, and well, we wrote alpha k before, but we already know what the best approximation is. Now h1 is the best approximation in h for the vector u, and we already computed that. That's nothing but the sum overall u times uk, scalar product of uk times uk. So yeah, that means every element of u can be written as the sum over all k, scalar product of u and uk times uk, plus an element h2. And h2 is an eigenvector of k for eigenvalue 0. So k h2 is 0. And that representation we will use in the next lecture to actually prove the singular value decomposition representation. I think there's not enough time at this point.